Are we in a bubble? Are housing prices going to crash? What is a recession? Are we going into one? These are the questions we're getting asked every day, and I am excited to talk to you about them today. So, are we in a bubble? No, we are not in a bubble. I feel like I understand the concern. I get why people are stressed about this. We have seen home prices, you know, go from 6% appreciation, which is normal, right? 4, 5, 6, to 20 and 30% over the last couple years. And that is kind of crazy. And we cannot sustain that. So luckily, we are seeing a slowdown. And what a slowdown means is we're not talking about existing values crashing. We're talking about future values, future appreciation. So will homes continue to appreciate at 20 and 30%? Per year? No. And that is a good thing. We need the market to get a little more level. So what we're talking about is seeing the market come to more of like a 4, 5, 6% appreciation, which again is more balanced, and seeing that people will hopefully be able to get into homes just a little bit easier. Are we going to go into a buyer's market? No. We are far, far from a buyer's market. We are completely in a seller's market. What is a seller's market? What does that mean? Well, what that means is, you know, really a balanced market is about 14,000 to 16,000 homes on the market. When we saw a crash back in 08 and we had a really big home price drop, we had homes of 40, 50,000 on the market, right? 60,000 on the market. Right now, we have 4, 5, 6,000 homes on the market. That is nowhere near a balanced market when you have, you know, 20, 30,000 buyers and you have 4,000 homes, 5,000 homes. So the issue is, you hear these headlines. I just saw one last week, you know, the market is slowing down, 12% price drop in listings. And those are things to watch. Those are telltale signs, and we need to watch what's happening. But keep in mind, a lot of these drops in price, we went from, let's say, 12% to maybe last year this time when the market was insane, where price drops were maybe 9%. So those drops are happening because sellers maybe went out a little too aggressive and listing agents were pricing homes based on what had been happening up until this point, and they went out a little too high. And with the market just leveling out a tad, those homes maybe were priced way too aggressive, and so they're having to come down just a drop. But when you still look at the price they're selling for versus what they bought, the amount of appreciation, we are not in a bubble. We are not in a home crash situation at all. The other thing to keep in mind, and we've talked about this a lot, is back when we had, you know, in 08, where we had the housing crisis, that is what caused homes to drop, and that is what caused the recession, was the actual home crisis. And that came from a standpoint of way too many people having loans that they really had no business being in. So they weren't qualified properly. We had different mortgage programs back then. People had stated income loans, you know, no income, no asset loans. The famous NINA is what they were called. All types of adjustable arms, and I mean crazy adjustables, like you're fixed for 2 years, you have a 3-year prepayment penalty, and your loan's adjusting in 2 years, and it's going up 6%, and you don't qualify for a refinance because you really never qualified the first time, and your value's now lower. That's what we experienced in 08. And so that's what actually caused the recession. However, every other recession in history, home prices actually went up and did not go down in a recession, because what happens is everything costs more, and so rents go up and people still want to own a home. And so what you're seeing right now are the tell signs of, you know, manufacturing, goods and services, those things, import, export, those numbers have dropped, and that shows that there's a lower demand for product right now than we had before. We're still obviously having way more demand than we have supply in everything. That's why you hear supply chain constantly. And that's why the government and the Fed keep raising rates to try to control inflation. So what you will see is over this course of this year and probably into the beginning of next, rates will continue to go up. But every single person that we follow that watches the market, that you know, is really involved with economic forecasting is saying that we are going to see rates drop again next year. Now, do we know how much and for how long, and can we guarantee it? No. No to all three of those questions. Nobody has a crystal ball. But if we look at history and we look at the signs, we can see that the Fed waited way too long to raise rates. They kept saying inflation was, you know, transitory, and we weren't really in an inflation market. And keep in mind that to predict or to call an inflationary market, they look at two quarters previous. So it takes a long time for those markers to come in, for them to officially call it. But last year, all year, we knew we were in an inflationary market, and really rates needed to be raised slowly and gradually. And instead, what's happening is this huge knee-jerk reaction, huge rate increases, which then causes the pendulum to swing, and then you will see rates, a recession next year, and rates come down. Again, nothing's for sure, but that is the predictions of everyone that we follow and listen to that are in our industry and have been predicting things for 30 years and have been correct pretty much every time. So my recommendation is buy the home. The values are going to continue to go up. Lock in today's home price. What if the rate's higher than you wanted? If you can afford the payment, buy the home. Lock in today's value, refinance, you know, next year when rates go down, and build appreciation and equity. That is the only way to counteract inflation. You counteract inflation with a home that it's appreciating higher than what you're paying in interest, and watching your equity grow as you make payments versus paying rent, 100% interest, and you're putting money in someone else's bank account. So give me a call, Michelle Otto, The Otto Group. Let us put together a strategy for you and help you figure out how to get into a home if it's the right time for you and ride the appreciation up, maybe not 20 or 30%, but could be 5%, 6%. And the other thing is, a lot of people last year were paying crazy over asking, and we were even nervous about that. Honestly, I made my heart, you know, jump watching people pay $150,000 or $200,000 over asking. But a lot of those homes, which had 20 and 30% appreciation, they have made money. So even in a crazy market like that, that was the right thing to do. Is it still the right thing to do? We need to watch what's happening in appreciation, look at the neighborhood you're going into, and see if you're going to be able to sustain and come out ahead. So give us a call, Michelle Otto, The Otto Group. Let us put together a strategy and get you into your next home.